how to write a sales letter that sells, how to structure a sales letter to create a persuasive presentation, how to grab the reader's attention to persuade him to put the credit card in your checkout. This is the great topic of this video, and I'm excited to share this precious information with you. I've been studying and practicing copywriting since 2009, and it was the first and most important skill I decided to learn. Using the written word to sell something is very powerful, since everything you write on the web is copy-oriented. To master this skill properly, you have to develop the right mindset and strategies to communicate like a pro without being salesy. In this video, I want to share with you 10 steps you need to include to write a persuasive sales letter. If you follow me on my YouTube channel, you probably know that I have a specific playlist about copywriting. In other words, I'm sharing the entire process and mindset to be a copywriter entirely for free. This is the reason why I suggest you subscribe to my channel and turn the notification on to be notified every time I upload a new daily video. If you like this type of content, type on the like button as well. Thank you. I want to make a premise. You can follow these 10 steps I share with you, even to produce your video sales letter. The structure and the concepts are the same. Obviously, the way you communicate in a video can be different if compared to writing something. It all depends on your style of communication, and it is very personal. Doing 10 small steps is more attainable than doing one giant sales message project. The job of each part is to move people onto the next part of the sales letter. Step number one, headline. How to write compelling headlines is a must for a copywriter. The headline is responsible for 80% of your success in writing sales letters. Headline is the only piece of your sales letter that everyone will read for sure. This is why it is so crucial to write it in the correct form. Now, I have a question for you. What is the purpose of the headline? Simply to attract attention from the right people. Keep in mind that you can write the headline package. In other words, a pre-headline, headline, and a sub-headline. Let me give you an example of a headline package that I wrote for a company that is creating a community to educate people using cryptocurrencies. Pre-headline: advice to people who want to learn more about the crypto market, even if they start from scratch. Headline: give me 7 minutes and I'll show you how to master the crypto market like a pro and get 10 tokens of our company completely for free. Subheadline: we are giving away 10 tokens of our company for a limited time and quantity. Read this page now and claim the free tokens as soon as they are still available. There is a lot to cover on how to write headlines, and it's not the purpose of this video. I'll explain how to write compelling headlines in other videos. Step number two, shocking statement. In this step, your primary goal is to shock people. They need to stop what they are doing and paying attention to you. People are distracted all the time, and your primary mindset when you write a sales letter is to grab their attention, ideally in every sentence you use. Here is what I wrote in the introductory paragraph. If I told you that you still had the opportunity to buy one Bitcoin for one USD, would you buy it today? Considering the value of one Bitcoin today, how much money were you willing to invest if you still had a unique opportunity to buy it for $1? Most probably, you would invest all the money you have. Pay very close attention to what I'm going to share with you on this page, because you have a concrete chance to have a similar opportunity. Step number three, define the problem. Without a problem, there is no solution. And don't forget that problems attract people's attention. If they don't identify themselves with the problems, facts you are eliciting, to attract their attention, they will no longer be interested in your message. Eliciting problems to which your product or service provides a solution is crucial to making a sale. There are different ways to define problems. For instance, you can start sharing a story of yourself or someone else by highlighting the struggles and difficulties you wanted to find a solution. I did an entire video on how to create a story related to your product or service in one specific video. I put the link on the description below. In addition, to define a problem, you need to answer a specific questionnaire that helps you put yourself in the potential customer's shoes. If you haven't watched it yet, you can find the link to this video in the description below. The point is this: your reader has to believe that you understand problems he is having right now better than himself. Once again, the key is to create empathy, and do not forget to agitate the problem, which means you want to make it hurt. Indeed, they don't buy if the problem doesn't hurt. Step number 4, provide a solution. Fortunately, there is now a solution to your problem. Let me introduce you to the first crypto company born to create awareness of the crypto world, help human beings understand how to move in this new and exciting world, and let people comprehend how to profit from this huge market. With this sentence, I have just introduced the company's service to fix the problems its potential clients have. When you introduce the solution, I urge you to think and speak about the advantages and benefits the client will get once he buys your product or service. If you have properly answered the questions in the product and offer creations questionnaire, this section of your sales letter will be straightforward to fill in. I urge you to watch the video I created days ago. Check the link in the description below. In this step, my suggestion is to use bullet points to arouse curiosity and desire for your solution. Step number 5, credibility statement about you. In this step, you have to answer a simple but crucial question. Why have I to believe in you and in the solution you are offering? Who are you to do this affirmation? Tell people why you are qualified to bring them this solution. This can be one sentence or a complete page listing your education, qualifications, and how you got to be where you are today. Step number 6, create a great offer. Regarding this step, I can spend hours speaking about creating offers. It's a topic that is very fascinating because you don't have any limits when you present your offer. And once again, if you have correctly answered the questions in the product and offer creations questionnaire, this section of your sales letter will be very easy to fill in. I want to give you an essential tip about creating offers. Check what the competition offers, especially if you are not selling a new product. Model their offer, and your primary focus is to add more value from your client's point of view. More value can be a fast delivery service or additional features or benefits that maybe the competition is offering with an additional product or service, and decrease the client's effort by using your product or service. They are just ideas. Step number 7, guarantee. Guarantee is essential, especially for your potential customers. They didn't know you because they haven't experienced your products or services yet. They don't want to risk anything. The stronger the guarantee, the easier the sale could be. There are two main types of guarantee: conditional and unconditional. Conditional means that the client has to do something with your product or service to claim his money back. Unconditional guarantee is the exact opposite. No questions asked to have my money back, just a simple request. Do not limit yourself with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Try offering 90 days or even 1 year guarantee. The longer the guarantee is, the better. Step number 8. Additional bonuses. Bonuses are a great vehicle to increase the perceived value of your product or service. Sometimes I bought an online course just for the more exciting bonuses than the introductory offer. The question is, what to include in a bonus? Listen to me. Whatever your competitors are offering that makes them unique, provide the same thing as a free bonus when people buy from you. That way, instead of comparing you to your competitors and trying to decide between the two offers, they buy from you because they see themselves getting everything they want without having to buy from anyone but you. Keep it in mind. Step number 9, call to action. In this section, you have to tell the reader what to do. Tell him, buy now this product or service. You have to be specific and direct to the point. For instance, act now. This 10 token free offer is very limited. We decided to give only 100,000 tokens. And do not ask only for a specific action, but add scarcity and urgency to your offer. For instance, this offer is valid till this week only for the following 23 clients. But pay attention, do not cheat on your clients. Urgency and scarcity must be real. Step number 10, postscript. There is always a postscript in every letter, and therefore you must include it in your sales letter as well. I suggest you have 2 or 3 PS. When you write a PS, keep in mind to restate the main benefits and tell your reader again to act right now. And remember to put some testimonials in different parts of your sales page, not only at the end. Video testimonials work like magic. Perfect! Let's do a brief recap of the 10 steps to write a persuasive sales letter. Step 1, headline. Step 2, shocking statement. Step 3, define the problem. Step 4, provide a solution. Step 5, credibility statement about you. Step 6, create a great offer. Step 7, guarantee. Step 8, additional bonuses. Step 9, call to action. And step 10, postscript. And that's it. Below this video, you can find the link to the landing page that I mentioned in this video, and you can check how I use these 10 steps to create a sales letter to collect potential clients. If you find the information I shared valuable, or if you think this information can help other people, feel free to share the video with anyone you want. It's a pleasure for me. And do not forget to subscribe to my channel and turn the notification on to be notified every time I upload a new daily video. If you like this type of content, type on the like button as well. Let me know your point of view by leaving a comment exactly below this video. Keep in touch in the next episode.